Dr. Santos, hi. My name is Kasia. Welcome to our show. It's great to have
Thank
you
Thank you. It's a great show.
So Dr. Santos is a CEO of a company called PiezoTech. They create a printable piezoelectric material.
Yeah.
So what is that used for? Maybe first tell me a little about the company and then show some of the applications you've developed.
So we are material supplier. Huh? Yes. We develop prototypes, products, inks, yes, polymers, and we are associated with a research institute and other startup company, yes, to develop devices and prototypes. So the polymers we develop are printable and, yes, electroactive.
Yes.
So it means our intent is to bring new functionality to printed electronic.
Yes.
Electroactive means that they can convert mechanical energy into electrical energy and reversely. Electrical energy into mechanical energy,
yes,
also thermal energy into electrical energy, and electrical energy back into electrical energy. Okay, so first application for that is for sensors. You,
yes,
can print sensors,
yes,
to pressure sensor, infrared sensor, ultrasonic sensors on large area, small area, any design you want. First application for sensor. Second application is for memories. Or in the depths of the material, there are dipoles that are switching when you apply electric field.
Yes.
And one application is to use it to make printed memories.
What about haptic? Is it possible to create?
So we develop. We are the only company that has produced modified polymers,
yes,
which is called Relaxor Terpolymer, PiezoTech-RT.
Yes.
And these polymers are very at the highest volumic electromechanical density of energy density.
Yes.
So this polymer, when you apply electric field, can move.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
And they can generate stress up to 20 megapascal or thing like that. So we have customers that want to use it and partners that want to use it to make actuators.
Yes.
For actuators, we are developing several applications. First, speakers.
Yes.
A sheet covered with a polymer. When you apply a voltage, it vibrates and creates sounds. Second, what you mentioned is, this is an example of a speaker here. You only have a polymer that you printed on a layer,
yes,
polymer with transparent electrode. When you apply a voltage here, you will not hear it. Huh? You have to connect it.
Yes.
Okay. But you can believe me, it is a speaker. Okay. And here, you can the same thing. You print devices. You can print it on plastic. You can print it on paper, and you will have actuators. When you put electric field here, then you will have actuation of the small plastic layers here.
Hmm.
So we have partnerships to develop haptic devices to make vibrate a surface. For example, we are collaborating with a company called Novasentis that want to integrate,
yes,
actuator in a wrist,
yes,
of wearables,
yes,
to create haptic feedback,
yes,
touch feedback. We have collaboration also in project to make steerable catheters,
yes,
with these materials to move. And also we have also collaboration with OEM to develop haptics on large surface, for example, for automotive dashboards.
How transparent can this material be? Because I see this one is a little bit transparent.
Yeah. So the problem of transparency right now is not because of our product, but because of the electrodes.
Transparent connection.
Yes. Here it's a P-dot electrode,
yes,
and you know that P-dot. So we are waiting for graphene, commercially available graphene or silver nanowire to have at the same time flexibility, easy printable process, and transparency. But the issue is not a polymer.
Is it possible to combine, using this technology, two functionalities, touch sensing and haptic feedback,
yeah,
in a transparent touchscreen device?
So, frankly speaking, yes, it's possible.
Yes.
You can put a layer of piezo thing,
yes,
and layer of haptic. Okay?
Yes.
But one issue is that in order to have low voltage, you have to have thin layers.
Yes.
In order to have high energy, you have to have multiple layers.
Yes.
Okay. So we demonstrated with our partners that you can print easily multiple layers,
yes,
up to 40 layers. I will show it after that, up to 40 layers. But the issue when you make multiple layers is that you have many interfaces,
yes,
and every interface will induce some refraction, so you will lose somewhere some,
yes,
transparency.
Yes.
So right now, if you need very strong effect and low voltage, transparency will be difficult to obtain. But there is some haptic application. This is the catheter. But there is some haptic application where you can put it behind.
Yes.
Behind, yes, the flexible touch screen.
And can you force? Can you sense force, not just touch, but force?
Yes.
Okay. So you can, you know, in theory, you might be able to combine force sensing, haptic feedback,
yeah, yeah,
and tight sensing in one device.
And even with, for example, infrared or,
yeah,
electronic, you can also have some kind of of form recognition.
Yes.
But I'm a material supplier.
Yes.
So I dream about what people can do with my product.
Yes.
We try to show what is possible to do, but in the end, of the people that will use this product.
Excellent, Dr. Pedro Santos, thank you very much again.
Welcome, thank you for your organization here.
Excellent, nice. How's the show been for you so far?
Very nice, I'll be there next year.
Excellent, we look forward to having you.
Thank you.